Welcome back to the beautiful sunny Swiss Alps. The release of the equatorial mode on the Seestar, especially with the later addition of the 60-second exposures, has unlocked completely new possibilities for deep sky imaging. But some users have noticed a problem. Even with a reported polar alignment error close to perfect, or sometimes showing zero, they're still seeing star trails or a high number of rejected frames. So what's going on? Is equatorial mode not working as it should, or is the polar alignment actually off despite what the software says? In today's quick video, I will share one of the most probable causes behind why some users are seeing this issue, along with an easy fix that will help you get perfectly tracked 60-second shots with basically no frame rejection. My name is Lucia, and you're watching The Space Koala. There are plenty of videos out there, including my own original EQ mode video that show you how to polar align your Seestar. Just to quickly recap, the usual process is to point the top of the Seestar towards the celestial pole, then it takes a first exposure, rotates by a predefined number of degrees, takes a second exposure. By comparing the two images and looking at the coordinates resolved in the second image relative to the first, the software can determine how far off your polar alignment is. You can then see that error in real time. You can adjust your screws or your ball head or your tilt and pan head until the reading improves. On paper, this method sounds perfect, and in fact, it's the same approach that the ASI Air and other software-based polar alignment algorithms use during polar alignment routines. After every adjustment, a new exposure should be taken so that the software can recalculate the exact error and give you updated feedback on your polar alignment offset. However, here's the catch. Taking exposures and plate solving takes time, so the Seestar by default doesn't keep doing this continuously. Instead, after that initial star-based calculation, it switches to using its internal sensors, specifically the gyroscope, to determine whether your adjustments are reducing the error. That's still useful. It shows you roughly how much you need to move and whether you're moving in the right direction, but if you want maximum accuracy, that might not be enough. The gyroscope can be off, giving you an incorrect reading. How can you be sure it's not recalculating from the stars during adjustments? Simple, you can cover the top of the Seestar with your hand, move it, and the displayed error still updates in real time, even though it cannot see the sky. That makes it clear it's relying on the gyroscope at this point. That's why there's a refresh polar alignment error button. When you tap that, the Seestar takes another picture of the stars, compares it to the original, and gives you a more accurate reading than the live view. However, for this process to be truly effective, the only movements that should happen are the ones that come from adjusting the wedge. If your tripod is wobbly or the terrain is unstable, the newly captured image, when compared to the first, may be influenced by additional sources of error. This is also very easy to show. Adjust until you get a zero error after refreshing polar alignment error, then quit the menu and restart the polar alignment from scratch. You may get a different number from the new readings due to these other mechanical factors that changed in the meantime. Here's the method I recommend for getting the most accurate polar alignment possible. Think of it as an iterative process. First, start the polar alignment routine. Adjust your wedge until the error is as close to zero as you can get, then tap the refresh polar alignment error button so that the Seestar takes another exposure and recalculates the error from the stars. If the numbers are different from before, make more adjustments and refresh again. Keep repeating this step until the refresh reading is stable and consistent. Once you're happy with that number, exit the polar alignment tool completely and start a brand new polar alignment from scratch so the Seestar captures a fresh set of star measurements. Then repeat the same process, adjust, refresh, and check until the error stays the same. When you can restart the routine and get the same result every time, you know you've nailed your polar alignment and can be confident that you can run longer exposures in equatorial mode without trails. Keep in mind that the actual tracking will always be subject to other mechanical parts like instability, wobbling of your tripod, wind, mechanical issues within the mount tracking, as well as the actual base of the Seestar. So these will limit the overall precision that you can get in the tracking. However, ensuring that you have the best possible polar alignment, you are taking care of every single factor that you have influence on. I hope this short instructional on how to get the best possible pole alignment with the Seestar has been useful, and that with this little trick, those of you who've had problems with the equatorial mode can give it another try and enjoy the possibilities that longer exposures in equatorial mode open up. If you've enjoyed this video or found it helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. It really helps the channel grow. And as always, clear skies and happy shooting the stars.